Let me ask you another question about the terrorism list. What process is afforded a U.S. citizen, not someone who's overstayed a visa, not someone who crossed the border without permission, but an American citizen, what process is currently afforded an American citizen before they go on that list?
I'm sorry, there's not a process afforded the citizen prior to getting on the list. There is a process should someone feel they are unduly placed on the list.
Yes, there is. And when I say process, I'm actually using half of the term due process, which is a phrase we find in the Constitution, that you cannot deprive people of certain things without due process. So I understand Mr. Good's idea, which is wait until your right has been taken from you, and then you can petition the government to get it back. I understand that that's his idea. My question is, can you name another constitutional right that we have that is chilled until you find out it's chilled, and then you have to petition the government to get it back? Is that true with the First Amendment?
Sir, there are strict criteria before.
That's not my question, ma'am. That is not my question. My question is, what process is afforded a United States citizen before that person's constitutional right is infringed? Then he's fine with doing it with the Second Amendment. My question is, how about the First? How about we not let him set up a website or a Google account? How about we not let him join the church until they can petition government to get off the list? How about not get a lawyer? How about the Sixth Amendment? How about you can't get a lawyer until you petition the government to get off the list? Or my favorite, how about the Eighth Amendment? We're going to subject you to cruel and unusual punishment until you petition the government to get off the list. Is there another constitutional right that we treat the same way for American citizens that we do the Second Amendment? Can you think of one? Can you think of one?
I don't have an answer for you, sir.